Hi, I'm Pattu from Free FinCal. Today, let's talk about the Nifty Total Market Index. This is a new index from the NSE. It was launched just a couple of weeks ago. And let's talk about whether this is something special when we compare it to Nifty 50, or are we going to get something extra because it says Total Market Index. So this Total Market Index consists of 750 stocks. So it contains stocks across the large, mid, small and micro cap segments. Just like the Nifty 100 is a combination of Nifty 50 and the Nifty Next 50, the Nifty Total Market Index is a combination of Nifty 500 and Nifty Micro Cap 250. Nifty Micro Cap 250 is something that we have reviewed some time back. So the most important thing that we must understand is that the Total Market Index may consist of 750 stocks, but that doesn't mean you are going to get 700 extra stocks literally when you add it to Nifty 50. So Nifty has got 50 stocks. Numerically there are 750, but in terms of weight, it is not really going to matter a big deal, because the weights are determined by free float market capitalization. If you look at the market capitalization of the NSE stocks, the top few stocks, even within the Nifty, the top 10 or 15 stocks, they will have such a high market capitalization, they will completely dwarf the rest of the stocks across the Nifty Next 50, mid cap, small cap and micro cap segment. So however way you add, or whatever number of stacks you add, whether it is Nifty 50, Nifty 100, Nifty 200, Nifty 250, Nifty 300, Nifty 500, Nifty 750, whatever it is, if as long as you are going to determine the weights by market capitalization, only the top few stocks of the NSE will dominate the index. So if you look at this now, if you look at the latest fact sheet, Reliance Industries has exposure of 6.98% in the total market index. Within brackets is the exposure in the Nifty 50. So you can see Nifty 50, it's 10.7. HDFC Bank 5.89 in the total market index, 9% in the Nifty, and so on and so on. So basically, it's essentially the same pattern. All the stocks will be identical. The weights will be different, but the ratio of the weights will be more or less the same. And so you are not going to get 700 extra stocks. You're not going to get something extra. So if you look at the since inception evolution of the total market index, that's the black line, and the Nifty 50 is the red line. And this single graph will tell you that you are not going to get anything extra by investing in the total market index. Of course, you are, when you actually invest in a total market index, you are going to get something extra, and it's going to be negative, because the fund manager has got to worry about 750 stocks. Okay, you can say there is algorithmic rebalancing of weights, etc. All that is fine, but even for the algorithm, it is a headache, right? So even tracking 30 stocks of the Sensex is not an easy joke. 750 stocks is it's going to be a nightmare. We have already seen in the case of any index beyond the Nifty 100, whether it is Nifty Mid Cap 150, Nifty Small Cap 250, Nifty 500, whatever it is, the higher the number of stocks that are beyond the top 100 stocks, the tracking errors are very high. We have already seen that in a previous video. So the same thing is going to happen. So you are going to get something extra, and it's going to be undesirable when you invest in the total market index. It just makes absolutely no sense to buy something that just says it's total market index. It's a fancy name. So let's look at the 10-year rolling returns. There are like about 1200 data points. The yellow line is the total market. The brown line is the Nifty. You can see there's not much of a difference. And if you take into account tracking error, expense ratio, and so on, basically they will lie on top of each other. Or the Nifty may be a little bit higher. And if I add the Nifty 500 into the mix, the Nifty 500 is the pink line. Now that sits on top of one, you can't distinguish at all. So it's basically the same thing, whether it's Nifty or Nifty 500. Many people, even I have seen you know, people who are you know, certified quants, they make this mistake and say, oh, you are wrong to compare this index as a benchmark of Nifty 500. You should only compare with Nifty 500. You should not use Nifty 50. That's just, it doesn't make any difference. It makes no difference at all. And this is the rolling standard deviation of the rolling volatility. Until about February 2019, you can see that the 10-year rolling standard deviation of all the three, Nifty 500, 50 and total market index, there's not been really much of a difference. And in fact, since the last couple of years, the total market index has become a little more volatile than the rest. Okay, the difference between the yellow line and the other two lines is not much, but still, it's become a little more volatile. So you really are not going to get anything extra. It's nothing special about the total market index. Please don't fall for gimmicks.